The question in this video is there any use for such a LED lamp when it's defective? Often in such a LED lamp there is a kind of electronic unit made with a rectifier, a small bridge rectifier, a high voltage capacitor, some whatever chip, and all the electronics get very hot, of course. They burn out, but the LED unit is often in good order. And I wanted to do this experiment earlier. You can saw such a lamp. You can open it with a saw. Such a saw, that's what I used. Not in this case, because this is a healthy one. But in case of one defective lamp, and then you find inside this, say, plate LED, and all these LEDs are soldered to this plate LED. And on the back side it's aluminum, and on the front side all these LEDs are soldered, and there are of course all kinds of connections made. And in this case I found that the circuit works on 94 volts DC. And the DC is of course generated in the socket of the, in the electronic circuit in the socket of that LED lamp. Well, it's very easy to remove all these small LEDs, heated up on a gas flame, not too hot of course, otherwise they really burn out. But when you have given it the right temperature, you can wipe all these LEDs off of this plate LED. And of course many LEDs will don't survive this way of desoldering, but surely you can hold 10 or 15 of them. And you can solder on the backside a small wire. It's here. Done that here, and find of course what's the positive and what's the negative. And the good thing is that it works on 8 volts, at least in this case. That's very interesting. It needs a somewhat higher voltage compared to a normal LED, like the ones here for instance. This is also a white LED, but this LED is made for a higher voltage, and that's very interesting. And that also means that you can easily reuse them. And I will demonstrate that. It's very, very simple. And the good thing is, it gives a lot of light. And I will demonstrate it now by giving these two LEDs. You can switch them in series. That's also very interesting, because all these LEDs are completely identical. And when you try to do that with, say, separate LEDs, say the standard separate LEDs, for instance, these ones, they are often, when you try to solder them, connect them in series, that doesn't work properly. It only works properly when the LEDs are completely identical. So, now the demonstration. Lift up the voltage here. And because each LED is 8 volts, now they are in series, so the whole thing will start to light up on approximately, you can see it here, on approximately 16 volts. And another good thing is that they are very fierce, so you can really use them for instance as a kind of a backlight in a certain electronic circuit, or of course also as a kind of voltage indicator or whatever. And that's very interesting, I think. So you can see on my workbench, now it's more or less completely dark, that even on this 18 volts, the whole these two LEDs send out a lot of light. Well, another application, of course, is to use that LED where you say battery. This is, by the way, an old battery, 9 volt battery, of course. And you can connect such a LED with a series resistor. That's my advice to protect the whole unit against a too high voltage. And when you connect it, you also have an interesting small lamp. So, I think it's a lot of light given such a small LED. And of course you can make a simple lantern with it or whatever. So, kind of interesting circuit and also very good for the environment. Thanks for watching.